So Jessica, welcome back.
Thank you.
You have agreed to answer more of people's questions about their pets. And they are what kind of questions?
Uncomfortable
questions about your pet.
They are.
So let's do that. And
I think the answers are more uncomfortable than that.
I think the answers are. So you were just playing with toys. I just saw that in the beginning. So
yeah.
Do you play with your dog a lot?
I play with my dog every day.
Yeah.
Yeah. It's a requirement. But I do want to tell you an embarrassing story because I didn't even know how to play with my dog when I first got them. And I will tell you that story, but first I want to answer some questions.
Okay, so we've got some questions that were submitted to us. And I think they're really good questions. We have one from Mark in Arizona.
Okay.
And Mark says that his local pet store has one of those vet plans where you can just pay monthly. It's a really good deal. It's a lot cheaper than the vet, and they include everything the vet does. What's your opinion of those?
Okay, so yeah, the answer is definitely more uncomfortable than the question. My opinion on those in pet store vet clinics is that I would avoid them. Even though it seems like you are saving money, you get what you pay for. And what happens in these clinics is that vets, even vets coming in from other countries that maybe studied in other countries that are trying to get their licenses here in the US, as well as newly graduated vets, are just being churned through these vet clinics that are inside of these pet stores. And I'm not saying that's 100% the case, but a lot of times it is the case. And what they're doing is going through just trying to get knowledge and experience. And really all that's happening is there's a template for a dog, there's a template for a cat. And they say, you know, a dog needs XYZ at this time, and in a year they need XYZ, and in 6 months they need XYZ, and the same thing goes for cats. And there's really no deviation from that. So when you go to a private-owned veterinary clinic, you are getting personalized care for your pet versus a template of what a dog or a cat should need. So you know, getting that personalized care to me is invaluable because I don't want my dog or my cat are not, you know, templates, right? They are individuals and their needs vary. I mean, I have multiple cats, I've had multiple dogs, and throughout the course of their lives, they need different things at different times. And so applying a one-size-fits-all template to an animal doesn't work for me. So I would stay away from those vet clinics if at all possible.
Okay, you ready for the next one?
I'm ready.
Okay, this one is from Margaret, and she is in, looks like, Albany, New York.
Okay.
And she says that her dog every now and then will get an upset stomach, and I guess it's kind of runny. This is why this is an uncomfortable question. And it gets all caught in the fur, and it's just really bad. But she's heard that the best thing to do is just feed the dog chicken and rice. It's mild, it's easy on the stomach. What's your opinion of that?
Yeah, so again, this is in no way intended to be medical advice or veterinary advice. However, I have done a lot of research on this, and while a lot of dogs can tolerate chicken and rice, I actually have come to learn, and I used to do that too. I used to feed, many years ago, I would feed chicken and rice. But the first thing I want to say is that if this is a consistent problem, if this is something that has been going on for more than, you know, 2 or 3 days, then definitely the first thing you want to do is consult your veterinarian because there could be something else going on. But fasting them for 12 to 24 hours is not going to hurt. So it's going to give their system a chance to flush things out. Make sure you're giving them plenty of clean drinking water, of course, but fasting them for 12 to 24 hours is not going to hurt anything. It could actually help the body get rid of some unwanted things, whatever is going on. But then, so chicken and rice, while it is a bland diet, and that's kind of where this all stems from, feeding a dog with digestive upset, rice is actually going to increase the inflammation in the gut. It could actually add gases because rice is going to ferment inside the digestive tract. So it's going to do the exact opposite of what you think it's doing inside of your dog's body. So, and I got this from Dr. Karen Becker. So she actually recommends, and I have started doing this a number of years ago, and I think it works wonders, to actually feed cooked ground turkey and cooked sweet potato. So a mix, like half-half of ground turkey and sweet potato, and that's also a bland diet, but you're not gonna get that fermentation inside of the gut causing additional digestive upset. So that would be my preferred, if you've gone to the veterinarian and they say you need to feed a bland diet, my preferred diet is ground turkey and sweet potato.
Okay, got the next question, and this one here is an unusual question.
Okay.
This lady thinks her dog actually has some type of ESP.
ESP?
Let me tell you what she's saying here.
Okay.
Melissa, she's in California, so that could explain it. But then again, we're in California, so I don't know. But Melissa said her dog gets along with everybody. It's a Cocker Spaniel. And the other night, she had a date from Tinder. And when that date came over, the dog growled at her date, and she likes this guy. But she's trying to figure out, does this dog know something she doesn't know? This sounds like a really uncomfortable question.
Actually, it has a very easy answer. And the answer is yes, your dog does know something you don't know. So while there's really nothing concrete about this, there have been studies done that show that dogs can tell when a person is bad. I would definitely trust what your dog is telling you on this one. Even though you may really like this guy, your dog is picking up on something that you're not, and I would definitely trust and run with that. Additionally, there have been other studies done where if you are with your dog out on the street or wherever you are, and someone is rude or mean to you, and then that person tries to be nice to your dog and hand them a treat, they will not take a treat from that dog because they know that that person has been mean to their owner and they don't like them because of that. So definitely trust your dog's instincts.
Awesome. Okay. This here says, is my dog a homeless dog?
A homeless dog.
Yeah. All right. So this is what's going on. Reginald says that he lives in a part of town that there's a lot of homeless people and they smell bad. And he says, my dog smells like a homeless person and I can't get the smell to go away. What would you recommend?
Well, okay, Reginald, I get your point. And, if your dog smells bad and you cannot, meaning you have bathed your dog and the smell is not going away, you definitely want to go to your veterinarian because there could be underlying issues going on. They could have some sort of bacterial infection, maybe a skin infection, and you definitely are going to want to treat that. So really pay attention to your dog. That's a change, right? If there is any sudden changes in anything physically going on with your dog or even with their emotions or with their behavior, you definitely want to first consult your veterinarian because there could be some underlying medical issue going on. And in this instance, I would say that's probably the case.
Okay, Jessica, also I've heard, and I'm not an expert, you're the expert, could their diet have something to do with the way a dog smells?
Yeah, actually, that's very true. Your diet can have something to do with the way your dog smells. And we actually touched on this just a little bit, like really, really briefly in the last segment of Uncomfortable Questions, because what you're feeding your dog could be not the greatest. And a lot of times this happens with kibble, especially because of the poor ingredients that are used to create kibble diets. But your dog's system could be rejecting it, right? And it could be causing increased yeast infections. It could be causing all sorts of things in your dog. So really, yes, your diet can absolutely affect the whole physiology of your dog. I mean, just like with humans, our diet affects everything about our bodies. The same is true with our dogs. So I do highly recommend researching and finding a fresh food balanced diet that's going to work for you and your dog. And again, we talked about that so quite a bit in the other video. So I will link the other video in the description below so you can go back and look at that and follow up with that as well, because a balanced fresh food diet is absolutely going to be the best thing that you can feed your dog, whether you make it yourself or buy it commercially, as long as it is nutritionally balanced, of course. And yes, it does completely affect everything to do with your dog, but the very first thing you need to do is consult your veterinarian and take care of whatever medical issues are going on, because it sounds like there could be maybe a skin infection or some sort of bacterial infection going on that's causing that odor in your dog. Again, I am not a veterinary professional, but I do recommend that you seek veterinary advice on this and have your dog checked out.
Okay, we got another question here from Abib in the United Arab Emirates.
Oh, wow, how cool.
And he said that he heard giving bones to a dog could actually be dangerous. That's not true. Dogs love bones.
No, absolutely. Giving bones to a dog can be dangerous. You have to give them the right kind of bones. First and foremost, never ever in a million years give rawhide to your dogs. That is just nastiness, right? It is full of chemicals and glue, and you do not want your dog ingesting that. So do not ever give your dog rawhide. But even beyond that, if we're talking about natural bones, we really need to be selective about what we give our dogs. Anything that is cooked, anything that is smoked, absolutely 100% no. Do not give that to your dog. It is very dangerous. It can get lodged in their digestive system. It can splinter and puncture their intestines. It's nasty. Cooking a bone is going to make it brittle, and that is, it also leaches out all the nutrients. So what's the point in giving them those bones anyway? But it makes the bone brittle, and that's when the bone can cause all that damage inside of your dog's gut in their intestines. It can get lodged in their intestines. They may not be able to actually break it down. I have seen some vet testimonies and pictures of dogs where they have had to go in to their stomach and open up their stomach because it was just full of cooked bones that they were not able to digest. So it's really a nasty thing. Also, what you can do though, because we don't want to just say, no, you can't do this, right? We want to give you an alternative, something you can do. Raw meaty bones are excellent to give your dogs. Of course, there is a caveat to that. We do not want to give our dogs bones that are, they're called weight-bearing bones. So if you're thinking of a pig or a cow or something like that, they're the leg bones, basically. So you don't want to feed weight-bearing bones, but other bones are fine. Rib bones are fine. As long as they are raw meaty bones are amazing. I also will give dogs, on occasion, marrow bones because they love the marrow in a bone, but you do want to do that under supervision, because once they get all of the marrow out of the bone, they've licked it all out of the bone, you want to make sure you take that bone right away, because they can get their bottom jaw stuck in there. So you do want to do that under supervision. So the reason that you shouldn't feed weight-bearing bones is because they are just too hard. They will break your dog's teeth. It's not safe to do so. But other bones, like rib bones, neck bones, there's so many different kinds. Like turkey neck is going to be amazing. Chicken feet are amazing. So again, raw meaty bones are excellent to provide your dogs, and I will link in the description below an amazing resource to let you know what bones are okay to give your dog and what bones are not okay to give your dog.
Hey Jessica, you said you were going to tell a story about embarrassing story about playing with your dog. Can you kind of fill us in on what that is?
Yes. So squeaking the squeaker got Kim interested. But yeah, so it is a little bit embarrassing because I never really had dogs growing up. My mom had a couple of dogs, but they weren't my dogs. And so when I first got dogs as an adult, I didn't really know how to play with them. And to me, like being a trainer now, that's kind of an embarrassing story. I didn't really know how to play with them. And it's understandable. And I see that a lot of people don't really know how to play with their dogs well. And to that, I would just say that every dog is different. Try out different toys. Some dogs really like to rough play. Some dogs are very gentle and don't like rough play. Some dogs are going to prefer to have you toss something so they can fetch it, maybe play frisbee with them. Some dogs really just want close interaction and want to play one-on-one with you in a small confined area. So the best thing to do is to learn your dog specifically and try out different things and see what they like and see what they don't like so that you can properly play with your dog, because play is so important. It builds bonds with our dogs. It helps build trust with our dogs. It builds communication. It helps build communication with our dogs. And really, play is a form of enrichment. So providing this enrichment to our dogs on its own, just standing standalone, providing enrichment for our dogs is amazing and required. But being able to provide enrichment that we are actually interacting with our dogs with is so much more important, because we're building that bond with our dogs. So playing with your dog every single day, I highly encourage it. I really truly say that it is a requirement, but find out exactly how your dog likes to play. And not all dogs like to play the same way, and not all dogs like the same toys. So figure out what your dog likes best and run with it.
Okay, Jessica, I really appreciate you answering these questions today. If somebody wanted to get more information about you or your training or your group, or could you fill them in on that, where they can get them?
Absolutely. Yes, I do have online courses, and whether you're a beginner just starting out and don't know anything, or your dog is pretty well behaved and trained, but you just want to brush up on some things and maybe improve what you're already doing, I've got you covered. I've got courses for all of that, no matter what level you're at. I also have a book, which I will link in the description below. I highly recommend every pet parent read this book. It is the foundation of training that I teach to every one of my in-home clients. Before we start working on anything else, this foundation is what we work on first. So I definitely recommend you check out that link and get the book. I also have a group, and I would love for you to join and share you and your dog. I would love for you to share what you're working on with your dog. Maybe if you're having trouble with something, I can help you one-on-one. And I really, really love when you join the group and share the wins, because that really helps everybody in the group. There are thousands of people there, and it really helps them and provides them with hope that they can do it too. The link for that group is in the description. Also, since you made it this far, go ahead and give the video a thumbs up, like it, and comment below and let me know what your favorite question was in this video, or maybe if you have another question and you would like for me to answer it in the next video. Whatever it may be, comment below. Also, if you haven't already, go ahead and click that subscribe button. When you do, a bell will appear. Click the bell, select all notifications. That way YouTube can notify you every single time I post one of these videos. And if you really want a well-behaved dog and to build that bond with your dog, there's gonna be another video popping up right here. I highly recommend you check that one out. Next is really gonna help you and your dog build that bond and relationship.